It's Kim Kesty here in the creative classroom at Spellbinders, and I'm super excited because I just love these kind of videos I'm going to create for you right now. We've got three items in a brand new collection called Winter Wonderland, so cute, and it's really geared for those quick and easy cards. So what I'm going to do, I created a little challenge for myself, and hopefully you can play along. I'm going to create five cards, and each card is only going to take 5 minutes or less. And okay, maybe you have a tiny bit of prep time, but we'll walk through as we go through each card. I'll tell you about that. But let's take a look at the three products. So this is what we call kind of a mini collection. It's called Winter Wonderland. It consists of a paper pad and two packs of die cuts. So you can already tell that a lot of the hard work is done for you. This is a 6x6 sheet. It's got 10 different designs, and each design is repeated 4 times. So you have plenty of pattern paper to work with. We kind of started out creating this collection by saying we need a real cute pattern paper just for general card purposes, and then kind of got on the ball with, oh, but wouldn't it be cute to have matching die cuts? So this pack is kind of all the printed sort of thematic die cuts. Super cute, match the paper, have all kinds of fun images. And then this pack, you'll see more as I pull them out too, is more geared towards sentiments. So this is called the Winter Wonderland Sentiments. So simply by marrying the two die cuts, the images and the sentiments, it is so easy to create cards. So that's definitely what I'm going to walk you through today. So again, paper pad, two die cuts. I'll kind of set those aside real quick right now. Now, as far as prep goes, the only thing I really did ahead of time is create my 5 card bases. So all 5 are white. A couple of them are top folded, a couple are side fold. But that's kind of the only thing that I actually did as far as physically creating the cards ahead of time. So you'll see, for example, on this first card we're going to create, we've got the card base, and I just went ahead and folded it in half. So again, really the only pre-work I did. Of course, I did a lot of sorting and having fun with the die cuts, so I guess we kind of have to count that in as a little bit of time. But for this card, I went ahead and sorted through my die cuts. So I picked this cute little reindeer from the images pack, and then I picked these two sentiments that I'm going to kind of end up stacking like this from the sentiments pack, so you can see how well they mix and match together. And then I just grabbed a little thing of gems from my extra little stash of gems there. So first thing I want to do when I create my card is get my pattern paper. So I flipped through my cute little pattern paper pack, and I just picked one that I thought would be really cute with the little deer, and I trimmed it to the card front size, which is, of course, 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. These are all standard size cards, so I didn't do anything super tricky there. So I'm going to go ahead and just adhere the pattern paper to my card base. Go on down there. And this one is fully covers my entire card front. So again, 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. Line it up there. And then for this first card, I'm actually going to do one single die cut on my card. So I went ahead and grabbed our new Essential Diamond. So this is a nested set. This happens to be the largest diamond in the set, and it's so cute. You guys really are gonna want to pick this up, because I think it's gonna be a classic that we use so many times in so many different ways, and not just for the holidays. But I'm just gonna lay this on. This gold happens to be also cut the size of a card base, so just by tilting my diamond there, I can fit it perfectly on that panel. And this is our brushed gold cardstock. A little die cutting action here. And I didn't want to do a lot of die cutting on these cards, because again, 5 minutes or less, right? You want to be quick. So there's my pretty little diamond. And you can see that this is actually created perfectly to fit the front of an A2 card base. So I'm going to show you that as I pop a little bit of foam adhesive on the back here. Love our little foam squares. Put one in the middle too. Longest part of creating this card, picking off the backing from the foam squares. But again, you can see as I kind of lay this down that I've got the exact fit to my card front. I just kind of want to make sure the two sides are lined up. So top to bottom, side to side, and you just pop that on there. Doesn't it fit perfectly? So again, this is the largest nested set. You could go smaller and smaller if you wanted to, you know, kind of create that fun look of layering them. But for this quick and easy one, I just chose the single diamond. I'm going to kind of start stacking from the bottom. So I'm going to start this sentiment because I kind of know where I want it in relation to the diamond, kind of centered right here. I'm just going to pop that in. And I love stacking the sentiments too. They're so fun. So don't forget to utilize the fact that they all coordinate so well. Cutting my foam squares in half for this one because it's long and skinny. And I'm just going to put it right above my original sentiment. This is one of the ones that says Merry Christmas. And you can see that these foil die cuts have a little gold sparkle. So cute. See, this one's not quite straight. There we go. Check it under and make sure it's straight. There we go. Much better. And then our little deer will have a couple of foam squares. Kind of want to make sure his little back leg and his antlers there don't get crushed or anything. So I'll put an extra one up there. And then he's just going to kind of so sweetly balance on top of this Merry Christmas. Maybe just overlap a tiny bit. Look how cute already. It's so much fun. Add a few little crystals. These happen to be our spectrum gems, but honestly, you could do kind of any kind of little gems on here. Our aura gems would be darling. They have a little bit more of a gold hue. And these guys you can kind of, you know, scatter around, use your own judgment. I tend to like to do some of them in pairs. And then a few singles scattered around. But I love the sparkle that the gems add, and such a simple embellishment. I know we probably all have a lot of gems in our stash, but there is our first card. And even with the die cutting, it took less than 5 minutes. So super cute. There's card number one. Yay. All right. Let me grab some components for card number two. Okay, so for card number two, again, I've got my folded card base. Got some red gems I'll pull in just a second. And for this one, I actually cut a mat of our pomegranate cardstock. So that's going to go on here. I chose some kind of more florally die cuts that I'll just kind of layer on. And then I did our pattern papers. That's cut a little smaller to fit my red card base and a little fern cardstock kind of band that's going to go along the bottom. I'll start. And this one has no die cutting at all, so this one will be super speedy. I think you're going to have so much fun just really kind of working through those different layers, checking out all the different patterns in the cardstock. That pattern paper pack is super fun. And then this green is going to go right at the bottom just to kind of create a little weighted effect on the bottom of my card panel here. Going to give it a little grounding, so to speak. Make sure that's lined up. So that gives me a really cute card base to kind of start layering on my different elements right here. A couple more foam squares. I think I will start with the ornament because it's kind of my focal point. It also has my sentiment on it. I'm going to kind of layer that like right around here so I can add some fun things to kind of tuck in and pop around. Put a foam square on here, but I think I'm going to end up gluing these guys on first. This one kind of cute, like tucked in here. Sometimes I just like to add a little bit of wet glue, and then I can kind of position it just right. I have that extra like second to decide exactly where I want it. This one can kind of tuck behind my ornament here. This pattern paper is quite busy in the back, so that's why I'm putting most of my, you know, focal points down a little lower. Tuck this little flower kind of top of that one, but behind the ornament. I want to make sure I don't cover up my sentiment. I love this guy. I thought it was so cute. Such a cute little nod to the holidays. Kind of tuck that in here because, of course, December 25th. I'll get a little bit of adhesive for this small little banner. I like the kind of addition of from all of us to the Merry Christmas sentiment. Very cute. Be darling to tuck a little family photo in or whatnot. And I might put a little bit of glue here just to hold that in place so it doesn't get wiggly. And then the last thing I want to do is bring in some of my red gems this time. Because I thought, oh, that would be super fun with the little festive red ornament. You guys can see how really just fun. I mean, obviously it did take a couple of minutes to kind of sort through my die cuts and kind of match up ones that I thought looked really pretty together. But that didn't take me so long either. Just laying out the die cuts and looking at them is so fun. Get one more baby one. There. So again, card number 2. Like super cute, especially with, like I said, that fun little extra foiling on the die cuts. I love that. It just makes it look so extra special, that's for sure. So there is card number 2. Absolutely love it. All right. So card number 3 is a fun one. I've got a little bit different color combination going on here. There's so many of these fun, like light blue die cuts in the sets also. But I thought, well, we've got light blue pattern paper and more blue tone die cuts. So how about if we do kind of a snowy theme? So I went in and a lot of these snowflakes actually came from the sentiment pack. So there are other elements in that sentiments die cut pack that are not just sentiments. So I think a couple of these are from the image pack and a couple of this sentiment pack. And then I've just got my fashion gold. I'll use those in a minute. So this time, because it was kind of snowy, I thought, well, what could be better than doing kind of a snowball die cut, right? So I just took one of my basic circles. I think this might be from the color, from the Modern Essentials circle die. But you can grab any circle that's, you know, kind of a medium size. Just die cutting our white cardstock here. Adds that extra little special bit of interest to your card. So I'm going to put the card base. Now the patterned, pattern paper. Now I did cut my pattern paper just a little bit smaller than my card front, so it has a little white edge. I thought that was kind of fun and crisp going on there. And so you have a little bit of a white edge around. Kind of love it. Now again, popping up my circle because why not? Always fun to add a little extra dimension. You wouldn't have to do this step if you were wanting to keep the card a little more flat. Certainly could do that. Just go straight to your card front. And I'm doing that not quite centered, but a little bit up from center. It's a little bit higher than. And then I'll start by adding my focal point, which is my trees, and build up from there. Get to these little pointy areas. I do like to cut my bigger foam squares. I suppose I could switch to my smaller ones too, but. And again, the pattern paper, as you can see by this card, a lot of our pattern paper in that pack has this really pretty sparkly to it also with the foiled accents. That makes it even more special. All right, so tree's pretty much going to go front and center. And then, of course, the Let It Snow banner is super cute. And how appropriate, right? I guess we wish we had more snow sometimes here in Arizona, but we can go up north and get snow. All right, so I love the little curviness. I'm going to kind of tuck it under the trees here and kind of have it be a cute little angle. So fun. Now these guys I can just kind of stagger around, and I actually don't mind that sometimes they're kind of hanging off the card front, because I'll go ahead and come back and trim those. I think it'd be really cute. So I'm just kind of giving the effect of snow falling down. Some I'll tuck under the die cut, some I'll kind of leave on top. Kind of like to look at these first and go, okay, his positioning looks pretty good. Actually, I think I am going to pop this one up. Kind of a larger one, so might look more like snow falling if I pop it up. And I'm definitely going to go ahead and add some accents, some of those fashion gold accents, and I'll do some of those on top of the snowflakes and extra ones just scattered around. So cute already. Might as well pop them all up. Why not? Now keep in mind, you guys can do the same method also with any of the printed die cuts. I know we have another really cute set called Oh What Fun, you will like. And you can do the same card making method with that also. Okay, so here's our fashion gold. Go ahead and decorate some of our snowflakes. As long as my fashion gold don't pop away. Come back. And I love these because there's all different sizes. You've got the little baby ones, medium, large. And then, of course, I'll add a few extras too. Embellishing is really just kind of the fun part. Again, kind of keeping them in groups of twos or threes. There's really no right or wrong way, that's for sure. Medium size. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Now all I have to do is trim my extra snowflakes away here. Just turn that over, see where it's hanging over. Trim, trim, and trim. So you can see between the cute falling on the paper, the darling die cuts, and then those kind of snowflake snowballs falling down, it turned out so super cute. And I love the gold accents that match the gold paper, or the gold foiling on the paper too. So cute, Let It Snow. So check it out, guys. Card number 3, all done and ready to go. So let's do one that, I'm going to do one where I did a little embossing on it, on the front of it. So again, just by adding the single embossed accent that I'm going to show you, just really brings this card to life too. So first of all, you can see that I have my folded card base. This one's a top fold, so it's just right there. Again, same size though, A2, which is 4.25 by 5.5. I've got our new opal gems here. I thought, well, those would be fun to use since they're a brand new color. Use those in just a minute. And then I've got a single panel of paper here that I'm going to use with our embossing folder. This is our scalloped embossing folder, or scallops, I should say. So bring in our die cutting machine. This is a 2D folder, so it doesn't need anything really fancy. The sandwich is super easy. You just put the folder on the directly on the platform, and then you put one cutting plate on top. And of course, my cardstock is inside. Roll, roll, roll. guy out. And I thought it was just a fun kind of snowy effect for my card front. Go ahead and add that on. And I might have to trim just a little bit off the bottom. I think I have this panel just a little bit long, but we shall see. Yep, it feels like it's a little bit long. There's a little bit hanging over here. So I'll just go ahead and take a shear, or you could use a paper trimmer. Trim that away. I wanted to make sure that the embossing didn't shrink up my paper at all. So now I have this fun little texture there. And I thought these little floral elements, plus the little hat and mittens, would make a really cute kind of wreath. A lot of these are kind of curved around. So I was like, well, let's have fun with it and create our own DIY wreath. Of course, I'm popping up just about everything here. I'm gonna start building my wreath. And then I thought the hat and mittens might be cute accents, like tucked into my little DIY wreath here. The hat at this end, the left side. Kind of like popped in there, cute. Again, all this foliage is so cute because it's so easy to mix and match and really create all of your own elements. You can see that I'm kind of creating my circle here, my wreath shape. Oh, put that a little lower, I think. And then I'm going to add in a couple other little branches to kind of round it out a little bit, but. I think my mittens will be cute here. I also think this would be kind of a fun project to do if, you know, you had a little group of girlfriends, they wanted to come over and kind of get that fun, like, card making night together. Fun activity for them. Especially if they're like, I'm not creative, I don't know how to make cards. You can show them exactly how easy it is. I did want kind of a little extra foliage tucked in here, but I don't need the whole die cut, so don't be afraid once in a while to trim your die cuts. And then you just have, you know, a little bit of leaf you can just kind of tuck in there, make it a little fuller. Same with this one here. Because I have those foam squares under, it's not so easy to sometimes to slide them or tuck them in. So don't be shy. Don't be afraid to trim them off. Right? So how cute is that? I've got all my fun little elements on there. And I picked Merry Christmas because I thought, no, excuse me, Merry and Bright. Merry and Bright. I thought it was fun, kind of a little bit more playful since I'm working with the hat and mittens, right? But of course, you could pick any one that tickled your fancy. Season's greetings, Merry Christmas. There's a ton in that sentiment pack. I'm going to tuck it in right at the bottom. Kind of let the wreath take center stage there. Yeah, so cute. And then again, bringing in a few of my little gems. These are kind of white and sparkly, so they remind me, of course, of a little bit of snow. And I also use these, too, to kind of round out my wreath, too. Kind of create the illusion of going around in the circle. So any spot where I think there's a little, you know, empty space, I can tuck those in. Never say no to a little extra sparkly. Maybe one on the hat right here. Maybe one on the mittens. Put that. One on each mitten. There. So the sparkly just really, when you, you know, kind of hold it up to the light here, just really adds that last finishing touch. That's so cute. And how easy is that, right? An embossed background, add your die cuts on top, and such a fun and special card. So that's four. It's four, guys. We only have one left. I'm so excited. Yay. All right. So very last card. I feel like this is maybe the most traditional Christmas card. I don't know. Just because the elements are so cute. So I have my folded card base. I've got a gold, brush gold panel, some patterned paper. This is some of those, you know, a little bit more gold gems. And then again, traditional, I picked the little wreath and the cardinal from the die cut pack. And season's greetings. And I thought, well, we'll do one extra die cut on this card. And this is another new die set similar to the diamonds I showed you earlier, in that it's a nested set. This time it is arches. And I love the arches. The arches are turning out to be perfect for so many cards. And again, they're releasing with holiday, but they don't have to be just for holiday cards, of course. They're just a classic shape. And I also should mention also that both of these die cutting shapes, the new ones, the arch and the diamond, also have a solid glimmer plate that matches. So that is super fun too. So I've got my elements, my arch, my pattern paper. And again, this is a top folding. Just show you that real quick. Top folding A2 card just for fun. Certainly could be regular too. I'm going to push a little harder for my brushed gold here. I'm centering my pattern paper there. I love this pattern paper with a sweet little mistletoe and holly and berries. So cute. And then for a little extra dimension too, you can pop up this panel on your card base. Just kind of pops it away from your card a little bit. Never have too many foam squares, right? And then, of course, this is trimmed slightly smaller than my card front. So just having those items trimmed ahead of time, of course, did save me time, but I promise you still can do these cards in less than 5 minutes. So isn't this arch cute? And this is not the biggest arch in the set. This time I think I picked like number 3 or 4 down the line of the nested sets. Largest arch will pretty much fill this whole card front. But I thought this size was super cute. All right, now I can just pop up my other elements, including my wreath. Like I said, this one's so simple, but I think it turned out kind of to be one of my favorites. Really pops against that crisp white cardstock too. Greeting next. And this time I did put my greeting just a little bit lower. I thought I would leave a little bit of white space below that wreath. You notice on my other cards, I kind of tucked it in a little bit closer. I think this one will be cute. You know, a little bit lower on that arch. So cute. I'm actually going to double up my foam square here for my little birdie friend. Because, of course, he wants to pop out too. Why not? Kind of hang out in my wreath there. And last but not least, I like this gold pack too. This has got two different shades of kind of a really pretty bronzy gold. You can mix and match them, or you could just pick one tone. A little sparklies here. Maybe one or two more at the top. And I never know where to stop. And I think I will call it stop. Okay, so look how sweet he is. He's just kind of perched there, just chilling out in his wreath. And of course, bringing that pattern paper in the back just ties everything together. And then our little foiled sentiment here. So cute. So that's our fifth and final 5 minute card. Maybe I should bring them all in and kind of stack them up. That would be fun. We've got our wreath and our reindeer and our snowy guy. And our ornament. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that. It's kind of a fun, quick and easy card session for sure. And again, super fun to do with friends, hang out, make a card. Everyone is going to have their own twist on it, which I absolutely love. But simple card bases, add your layers, and you are good to go. So again, hope you enjoyed this winter wonderland little card festive fast card making project. I really enjoyed it. Hope you check out our winter wonderland paper and two sets of die cuts soon. And of course, you can find them, as always, at SpellbindersPaperArts.com.